While we may at times disagree, as friends sometimes will, the bonds between the United States and Israel are unbreakable. And the commitment of the United States to the security of Israel is ironclad.
President Obama, facing harsh criticism over his Mideast proposal announced just last week at the State Department, the president this weekend reiterating his call for negotiations that would create a Palestinian state based on 1967 borders. That would be borders that existed before the Six-Day War, along with land swaps between the Palestinians and Israel. The president and his comments at a rally, at a speech in Washington, not sitting so well with our ally. And now there are questions, new questions, about the future of Mideast peace and talks on that. John Bolton is a former U.S. ambassador to the U.N. He's a Fox News contributor. It's nice to have you here in our studios.
Glad to be here.
Thanks for being here. So the president speaking to AIPAC, which is the largest pro-Israel lobbying group in the United States, and he said that this is long-standing U.S. policy, that he was simply coming out and clarifying it, but that this is really the way that the U.S. has, this is what the line that we have towed for many, many years. Is he right?
He's flatly wrong on that. If you go back to the foundational U.N. Security Council Resolution 242 after the 1967 Arab-Israeli war, that resolution calls for all states in the region to live in peace within secure and recognized boundaries free from threats or acts of force. It doesn't say anything about the 67 line or anything else. And I think it's a key point here. That 67 line was a 1949 armistice line. It simply reflects where the Israeli and Arab armies ended up the conflict. There's another armistice line, too, the 1973 armistice line, which is Israel's greatest extent of control. If you're going to start with any line, why not start with that line?
You know, a lot of people within the administration who are trying to come out and explain the president's position say that, look, this was essentially the deal that was on the table in the late 90s in the Clinton administration when the Israeli prime minister at the time, Ehud Barak, sat down. He offered the same exact kind of arrangement, and of course it didn't come about.
Well,
but what's the difference?
Right, there was a small problem. The Palestinians rejected it. You know, I think, though, that just talking about whether it's the 67 boundary or whatever and talking about land swaps, which is kind of a trivial little word, really understates the real issue here. It's not where you draw the line on a map. It's whether Israel has confidence that the people who live on the other side of that line are going to acknowledge Israel's right to exist and its ability to live in peace and security. And that is very much open to question.
And here you have Hamas, which is a known terror organization.
Right.
Benjamin Netanyahu likens them to the Palestinians' version of al-Qaeda. And this is a group that has a major say. They're in partnership within the Palestinian sort of government apparatus. So how can we do any kind of business? How can the Israelis be expected to sit down for talks with a group that has come out and said, we want you off the face of the earth?
Well, I think you've put your finger on it, and it's really why I think any idea of advancing the Israeli-Palestinian peace process now is completely futile. The lead group in the Palestinian government, Fatah, which renounced terrorism before, although many people doubt that, has concluded a deal with the terrorist group Hamas that essentially puts them in coalition. So I don't think there's really anybody responsible on the Palestinian side for Israel to talk to. It mystifies me why the president raised this whole subject.
Do you sincerely believe, Ambassador Bolton, that the Palestinians want peace, that the Arab world wants a peace deal between the Palestinian people and the state of Israel?
Well, I think that Palestinian people have been used by radicals and extremists in the Arab world for a long time to be the tip of the spear against Israel. And I think now is not the time, with so much in turmoil in the Middle East, to think that we can go ahead and create a Palestinian state. Look at what's happened in Egypt, where leading politicians are calling for major modifications of those Camp David Accords, which has been a foundation of our effort for peace and stability in the region for 30-plus years. So I think it's a very inopportune moment for the president to raise it, unless he intended to try and squeeze Israel, which many people believe.
John Bolton is the former U.S. ambassador to the United Nations. Mr. Ambassador, thank you very much.